It is thrilling to watch whales close up, and our next guest has one of the best jobs in the world because she does this full time. Marine biologist Micheline Jenner has researched whales for the past three decades, and she discovered humpback breeding grounds off the Kimberley coast. Now she's revealing more of the secret life of whales, so let's everyone welcome Micheline from Perth. Yay!
Thank you
for joining us. In all your years of studying whales, what are some of the most surprising secrets that you've uncovered?
Oh, well, when you're close to whales, that's quite an incredible experience. We had one whale crazy, and she swam around and around the boat, and my husband got in the water to see if we could find out what gender this whale was because of the behaviour she was exhibiting. And she wanted to squash it. There's a picture of crazy right there, and she wanted almost to squash him against the side of the boat. And so he got kind of lost his nerve and climbed back in the boat, and he was able to tell she was a female. And then she actually lay her pectoral fin on the bow of our boat. And during that time, I thought, if I was a whaler and I was so close to such a magnificent creature, there's just no way that I could kill that animal, if that's right.
Wow, no wonder she was called crazy.
Now, they are mammals, and do they like to play and think like we do?
They certainly do, Denise. Nice to see you there, Denise. Humpback whales are mammals, they're marine mammals. They breathe air, they have hair, and they have hair as little spiky hair on the underside and the upper jaw, but they also care for their calves. And exactly that, they play. And sometimes you can see a cow and a calf together, and that mum is teaching the calf all these amazing behaviours of what it's like to be a humpback whale. And some of the footage you've got there is fluke slapping, inverted fluke slapping, and sometimes you can really see a mum teaching a calf.
They are just the most extraordinary creatures. They're my favourite animal. There's all this mystery as to how they evolved. And of course, they sing. And your team has actually recorded whales singing. Why do they do it? And is it true they actually nick hit songs from each other?
That's right, Joe. The songs that humpback whale males sing are love songs. They're singing songs to attract the females and to say that they're the finest and the best and the most available on the block. So they sing on a 45-degree angle. They lie down in the water with their pectoral fins outstretched slightly, moving their pectoral fins to stay still. And they sing for 20 to 30 minutes at a time, and then they can sing for the rest of the day for hours on end. And this is to attract females. And I have to tell you, I've been smitten more than once.
So, Micheline, why don't we have a listen to one of your recordings?
Sure.
Sound a little awkward, but Micheline, tell us what you think's going on there.
Well, this song, the humpback whales sing, is the most complex in the animal kingdom. And the scientists have worked out that each song is called a song because of the repetitive patterns. And then there's phrases, the theme, then phrases, sub-phrases, and the smallest portion of a song is a unit. And these are repeated over and over. And they have deep tones, as you're hearing the deep guttural and then the high shrills. And this is very characteristic of humpback whale song. A few years ago, that isn't amazing. And a few years ago, as we were coming down the west side, all the humpback whales we were recording were making this wah, 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 wah song. So every year, the song of a humpback whale in a particular population begins in one particular way with the themes and phrases, and then it gradually changes over the season.
Wow. Isn't that amazing? Stunning! And so they then spread their song to other humpback whales?
That's right, yes, Jessica. And that's exactly what happened. We recorded a whole series of humpback whale song from the Dampier Archipelago in the mid-90s, and we shared it with our East Coast Australian colleagues. And they found out when they were recording on the East Coast that about two or so of the whales in the 96 recordings on the East Coast had WA song. And then by 97, there was half of the animals in that population
had learned the song.
That's right. And then by 98, so 3 years, all of the whales on the East Coast were singing our WA song.
Oh,
so
wow.
That they is were amazing. Belting out, that's right, our WA top 40.
Oh, my God. So there's East Side and West Side. They're basically like US rappers.
That's Isn't right. that amazing, it though? Is.
Are you ever tempted to join in? Do you sing to them?
You would. You would.
Well, that's right. Well, no, I mean, when we're in the water, we do kind of squeak on our snork a little bit, make some funny squeaks and things. Their song is ever-changing. And as this study alluded to, it was novelty was the reason why they, the East Coast whales, took on our West Coast song, because wow. it might have been a new hit, basically, to attract the females. Isn't that incredible?
It is incredible. Micheline, wow. we've got another recording, so let's have a quick listen.
Wow.
So unique and incredible. Mm, Micheline,
it sounds a lot like One Direction's latest stuff.
What's the story behind that one?
Oh, well, again, this is a male, and this male is very creative, and it's doing these high-low tones and low tones. What they're doing is they're squeezing air between sacs, the blind sacs leading off the trachea. So it's like a balloon. You know when you have a balloon, a party balloon, and there's just a little bit of air left in it, and the kids like to make a terrible sound, and they, you know, open and close the mouth of it, of the balloon, and that's what they're doing. And this air is coming in and out. We had one whale in the Kimberley that had a 48-minute song. And it was about 37 degrees in the Kimberley and Camden Sound.
Oh,
the water was calm. It was quite hot. We were sort of, perspiring. It was hot. It was very hot. And we're sort of counting. So when is this whale coming? Okay, Julio. Okay, Tom Jones. Okay, time to come up. Yeah, so, and this whale, what we found in Camden Sound is at the beginning of the season, the young males only have about 11 minutes duration of their song. And as they get older and more mature, those mature animals at the end of the season, where they're more prevalent at the end of the season, are singing longer songs. So the young ones have to learn from the old ones.
Yeah, look, I've got to say, Micheline, even at 11 minutes, they're still not going to get played on commercial radio. They've got to get it down to three. My very, very favourite animal is the blue whale, the largest animal on Earth. And they really are enormous, but you're worried that they may not be able to survive.
That's right, Joe. These blue whales are... we work on pygmy blue whales in the Perth Canyon, and as you've got there, they can be up to 30 metres long. That's an insane... That's a bendy bus. If you think of a bendy bus beside you. Blue whales are feeding in the... Well, Antarctic blue whales feed in the Antarctic, and then during the rest of the year, they disperse throughout the oceans of the world. So our pygmy blue whales in Western Australia, they feed in the Perth Canyon, and then they go up to Indonesia. And the Antarctic blue whales also range across the Indian Ocean. But because they're dispersing, they're not feeding their own ecosystem. So humpback whales, they're down, they're heading towards the Antarctic right now. They've had the whole winter breeding, and now it's time for feeding. So they're on the way to the Antarctic. And where they feed, they also defecate. So they fill the very ocean with poo, and they are part of the poo and food cycle down in the Antarctic. Mm. Whereas, and that's a captive audience basically down there. So they're feeding the cycle there. Whereas these blue whales
that travel are not able,
that's right, they're not able to fertilise the ocean.
Micheline, we really appreciate you sharing your part of your extraordinary life, and of course those recordings, and giving us an insight into these majestic mammals. Micheline Jenner, her new book is called The Secret Life of Whales. Thank you so much for your time today.
Yes, fascinating life you've had. Thank you, Sandra, it was lovely.